Guys, welcome to Chawla's Kitchen. Today is Friday and we are gonna have a party. So, thought of telling you guys how to make some appetizer for our special party. What I am going to make today is the honey chili potatoes. Very easy recipe. You know, you need to have some ingredients and your taste buds will say, oh my god. So, let me introduce you what ingredients we need for honey chili potatoes. Very easy. Sometimes you need to have fried things, so we will fry this potato veggies. I have you can see I have Ore Ida. This is a brand name which we get from Sam's Club. So you can get this golden crinkles potatoes from Sam's or Walmart, smaller bags in Walmart and bigger packs from Sam's. So I like using this one, so we'll deep fry this. Yeah, you, once in a while you can, you know, have deep fried things, that's okay. And what else? So these are the potato veggies we need. And for our sauce, we need some onion. I am using around half medium sized onion, a lot of ginger, you can say an inch of ginger, and a lot of garlic. I would say this is like 2 tablespoons of garlic with some cilantro. And spring onions if you have. I'm not putting spring onion there at this time. Condiments, you just need salt, that's it. And for garnishing, we need some sesame seeds and we need honey, because it's called honey chili potatoes, so secret lies in honey and chili. So here I have chili sauce and I love to use this chili flakes I have. So let's get started. Whenever you take it from your fridge, you know, just defrost it for around 2 to 3 minutes, and my oil is already heated up, so let's start up. My oil is heated up, so it has to be a lot of heated up. And be careful while cooking this, because when it's frozen, it really, you know, bubbles a lot. So be careful in putting all the veggies. Put it slowly. Take around, I would say, 15 to 20 minutes to get it deep fried. So we have to be patient in deep frying it. If you guys don't like deep frying it, you can bake it, but yeah, I like it deep frying. That's the reason I am deep frying it. So I'm just tossing it, you can say tossing it, just turning the sides, just give it some while, and I'll put a heat on medium to high between that. So in the meanwhile, we'll prepare our sauce. For the sauce, my oil is already heated up, and you can say you can see the potato veggies, it's already getting deep fried, so it will take like 10 more minutes. In the meanwhile, our sauce would be ready. Here goes some garlic. Make sure this dishes really need a lot of garlic and ginger. Give it a stir. Well, of course, my ginger and garlic. We have to give it like stir for 1 minute, and we'll put our onions, because our oil was really heated up a lot, so I'll not give it much time. So onion, we'll give it like one or two more minutes. And then we'll be putting our honey and some sauces, and in the meanwhile this will get ready, potato veggies. And make sure whenever you are ready to eat this honey chili potato, then only put this potato veggies into the sauce, else don't put it, because otherwise it will get soggy. So if your guests are coming at your home, you know, you can make it sauce and you can fry this veggies and just put it in the sauce and stir this for a while, and then only serve it hot. We don't want to overcook our onions, so we don't want it to brown or something. So just give like 2 minutes. Here goes some salt. Salt really according to your taste. I'm using around 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Trick of this dish, a lot of honey. If you guys, you know, have ever been to Yo China, this is a real dish of Yo China. And I learned this dish because I love this dish. I used to go every week to Yo China just to eat honey chili potatoes. And no worries, you can make any honey chili potato, anything at your home now. So no much trick, sauce is really easy. Here goes the chili sauce. So use around 4 tablespoons of chili sauce in this. It really flavors good when you put a lot of chili sauce with the... So I have used around 2 tablespoons of my honey and around 4 tablespoons of chili sauce, you can say. So here goes the chili flakes. I don't put it really at that time because it will really get into your house and your kids, or you will really start sneezing. So put the chili flakes at the time you just wanted to put your potatoes. So give it a mix, and our sauce is ready. So I'll be putting my potato veggies now. Let me check where it is. Isn't it looking really crispy? If you don't have Walmart, Sam's near your house, you can cut the veggies, you know, in this way, lengthwise, not too much thin, not too much thick, and you can get the same thing at your house, deep fry it and make sauce like this. So you know, I'm just going to put some potatoes to show you guys because I'm going to make it for the party. You just, you know, make a sauce and just keep it on the side and put all the veggies at the time you are ready. So at this time, just give it a stir. Put more fries here. And these are really very nice and crispy fries. You can just put, you know, salt in it and eat it anytime. Your kids will also love it without sauce, of course, because chili sauce is a lot in this recipe. So just switch off the heat, and here goes a trick, sesame seed. Lovely, it's really a lovely thing to put in this recipe. Some sesame seeds. Wow, look at the color. And if you guys have spring onions, of course spring onions goes in it. I don't have right now. You can use spring onions. I'm going to use some cilantro on it. Look at the color. Isn't it amazing? It's really amazing. Look at the color. Look at the texture. Really good dish for party. So you can have once in a while and doesn't take much time except deep frying. And try out this recipe. Leave me comments. Leave me suggestions how you like it. And I really want to taste it. It's amazing, out of the world. And if you guys like vinegar, you can add it if you really like more taste. I don't like vinegar in this recipe. And leave me suggestions, leave me comments how you like it. And don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe on my channel to know more videos. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.